Hey, we're back out in the shop. I was thinking about this Whirligig I bought in Maine about 2 years ago. It's a nice little Whirligig, kind of looks like an antique, but the problem of it was on the pivot, it just had a hole drilled in the base board. So it just has a hole there. And it needed a bearing, it needed something. And I didn't want to modify it because I wanted to keep it as I bought it. So I came up with a method to allow your Whirligig to rotate in the wind simply and easily without any kind of a bushing or bearing or a tubing in there. It was kind of a spin-off of that to prevent the Whirligigs from flying away. I had a lot of airplane Whirligigs, and frequently they would fly off. I had some on the top of the house and they would fly off and land on the sidewalk and break. I never actually had anybody come by and like take a Whirligig off my mailbox. I have one on my mailbox. Never had a problem with that. They don't seem to be popular to be stolen. But anyway, I came up with a method to keep them secure and keep them from flying away. The reason I make my wings so small on my airplane Whirligigs is they do tend to fly. Fly, you know, up and downwind and crash into the sidewalk of the street and inevitably break. Usually the propeller blades break, but you can really do some damage. So I came up with this method. You can use this method on almost any Whirligig. I'll show you just using some sheet metal. Okay, the things you're gonna need for this Whirligig pivot mechanism, the first thing you're gonna need, 3/16 metal rod. And then the key to this method of security is these Dubrow wheel collars. These are for radio control planes and they keep the wheels on. And I'll show you how this works in a minute. The other thing you're gonna need is a piece of sheet metal. So this is 26 gauge. You could go a little less. I find 26 gauge is about 18 thousandths of an inch, something like that. It's cut pretty easily with just a pair of these are called aviation snips, 10 snips. Air conditioning ducting under the house is usually a little thinner than this, but it works great. So sheet metal, and I just use this steel, galvanized steel. You could use or sheet metal. You know, you can go to hobby shop, go to Michael's. I think this is Michael's. This is copper sheet, pretty pricey. You get brass sheet at the hobby shop in strips. You can get a 1/2 inch strip, 3/4 inch strip by 1 foot for $1.99 brass. Okay, so with that in mind, you use these to cut out a little strip. And I'll show you where we're going before I start in on the work. So here's a simple Whirligig. So it's just a stick. I just put the piece of this sheet metal I cut out about 1/2 inch, about 1/2 inch by 1.5 inches, and put it over the hole on the top with 2 wood screws that go right into the wood. There, and that, like it's on roller bearings. Look at that, super easy. Maybe I want to get in there and squirt some oil on it, squirt some 3-in-1 on it. So I made a little hump in the metal. Same thing. And then you can see the action in there. Now here's where I came up with this idea of a security so it wouldn't blow off in the wind. And if you take this little piece here and put it on the bottom, we're gonna put this on the bottom, right? We still have one on the top, but we're gonna put one on the bottom too. And drill the hole in it, 3/16 hole for the shaft. And then in the little hump, we're gonna make that hump wide enough to insert a Dubrow wheel collar, 3/16, they're labeled by the size of the rod they will go over. You put the wheel collar inside here, and they tighten down with a set screw. The other thing that if you really want it to be secure is you want to probably thread this rod. You thread your 3/16 rod into your, let's say this is a fence post, your mailbox, a pole. So what I plan on doing is putting a thread on this 3/16 rod. First thing I want to do is get all my components laid out, and we're going to start with the sheet metal here. I have a little piece of scrap, so I'm going to mark something slightly larger than 1/2 inch. Just just gonna mark this. The thing we have to worry about here is having room for the collar to fit in. And these little set screws that come with this are just incredibly tiny. And these little collars come in really handy for whirligigs. They actually are made of brass. Let's make it 5/8. That way we got plenty of room for everything we need to do. I use this black Sharpie. It's great for marking out. This says fine point. It's really not very fine. And the width, where I'm gonna do the bend. Let's figure out where I'm gonna do the bend. So these collars, these Dubro wheel collars, are 3/8 of an inch. So you want to have room for it to rotate underneath there. And you want it to be pretty close to the center. That'd be the best thing. This is 3 inches, the length of this piece. You can always cut it if it's too long, but so let's mark this nice and square. 3 inches. And we're gonna make two out of this piece. So now the center 3 inches is 1.5. Put a mark there. I'm gonna use the square. Alright, that's gonna be the center. It's 3/8. I love these circle guides for all making whirligigs and marking out things. There we go. So the bend marks, the bending marks are gonna be right on the edge of these circles. So this will be a bend mark, bent. Bend it here. I don't know if those will show up on camera. Pretty easy. I mean, you don't have to do all this layout work if you don't want to. Just makes it look better. And then your screw holes. We want to get those, you know, looking pretty symmetrical also. So let's put the screw holes 1/2 inch from the edge. And the screw holes are going to be probably 1/8 of an inch, something like that. You don't have to do all this if you don't want to. Just keep it accurate. And you want it in the center between the 5/8 there. You want it in the center. 10/16. So if you go to 5/16, 2, 4. That's the dead center there of the. So that's where your hole is going to be. Drilling holes in sheet metal. Best to clamp the work in a vise. Use a drill press and clamp it down because a regular drill bit will spin. It'll catch, as soon as it breaks through, it'll catch an edge of the metal and spin this sheet metal, and it could, you know, it could really rip your hands up. So clamp this up before you drill it. Now there is a tool you can get at Harbor Freight and Market to drill holes. It's this cone drill, and they're marked in sizes, but this is specifically for sheet metal, and these work really well. So let's put a punch mark on the center. And here's a little trick: when you're using a punch, if you move, find the line you drew with your scribe, and just slide your punch very gently along until it hits the cross line. It will catch in the cross line, and you don't even have to look. That's dead center. If you look at that with a magnifying glass, that's going to be dead center. So here comes along the line, it'll stop. Use a real lightweight little punch. Just slide it along the line, catches right in the cross line. Perfect. And you don't even have to look. And you can see these punch marks are right on center. And the drill will pick that up and go right through. First, I'll trim this little piece off. Cut this. course, I'm not gonna bend this yet until I drill it. I think I'll drill it first so I have something to hold on to before I cut this. That'll give me more grip area. So I've got a chunk of 2x4 here. Get rid of these. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use these bits, it's called step bits. And I was introduced to these by Mr. Pete 222 on YouTube. He is a master machinist and instructor. So I'm going, these are marked in sizes. I'm gonna drill this to 3/16, and we use 3/16 for everything else. So 3/16 is the one, two, it's the third step in. And I'm not gonna hold this by hand. I'm gonna clamp this. Okay. Holes drilled there. So next we're going to cut it. We'll have two of these, and then we'll bend it. These were Harbor Freight. These are straight. You can get these to cut aviation steps to cut left and right. And these are straight. So there's one blank. So we're going to, let's make another one. Let's 26 gauge sheet metal. You wouldn't want to go much thicker than this. It'd be hard to cut. But you could definitely go thinner. You can go with brass. And copper gets a little expensive these days, but if you really want to, you know, look fancy, look antique, whatever, copper's nice. So I'm gonna mark this based on this one. Just quick and dirty. Okay, now, next step is to bend these. And I'm gonna use the vise. If you don't have a vise, these things here are great. Sheet metal pliers. These are locking sheet metal pliers. So you can just take stuff in here like this and bend it like this. See how we want to do this. Stuff's pretty soft. And we'll do the other one. Now here's a little trick. If you take a little piece of metal, I have just a squared up metal bar. It's like, this is a 1/2 inch by 3/8 inch metal bar. And what I do is I clamp this in the vise fairly straight. I think I could use this as kind of a little mini bending break, like this. It really makes for nice straight bends.
level with the top of the whirligig. So, you know. The nose of it is too big, it gets in the way. So I want these two ears to be even right here. So this is flat. So that when that goes on your whirligig, it's flat across the gig like that. See how that's gonna work? Now I've got to, for this one, I'm going to drill a 3/16 hole right here in the center of this. This one's not going to get a hole. Okay, just see how this little bending jig works. It's pretty neat. Use vice grips to hold this. Right like that. And you want to make sure it's a level. It's 90 degrees. You want your bends to be 90 degrees so you don't get an angle. Step is take this off, do it this way. And I didn't get that very good. So you can, once you bend it, they don't come out. And you can just manipulate it a little bit. Need to drill this one. Need to drill both of these. Okay. That's got to be fixed. That's no good. Let's redo that. So then it really squares up. That little sanding thing with the rubber inside. now, moment of truth. Got the airplane. Here's the pivot point for the airplane. Here's where this is gonna work. So there's a regular pivot pin. This airplane has flown a lot over the years. Here's the little bracket. Goes on there like that. Then I'm gonna have two of these brass screws, wood screws, to go right in here. So I'm gonna drill a little pilot hole so it doesn't split my wood. And it's probably important to mark these holes with the pivot pin in place so it locates them accurately. The pivot pin's getting in the way. I'll just do the first one.
There goes, that's it.
3/16 wheel collars. Slide this in here. Tighten this up with a little set screw. Now I'm probably gonna file a little flat on there to make it even harder to get out. And then you could lock the screw in with some Loctite. If you really wanna. Yeah, that's a problem. It's hitting. The set screw is hitting the side of the sheet metal, so that's something to look out for. Put the pivot post in first. So let's do that. We'll put the pivot post in first, and then put glue on it or screw it in. Nice, screw it down nice and tight. Okay, I've got my 3/16 rod clamped in the vise. So we're gonna try this with, this is a 12-24. And I'm starting the die in on the with the side that has the writing on it. It's usually the way you start them. Look at that. Cutting right in. A little oil. So back it up a quarter of a turn, go a half, back it up a quarter. When you back it up, it breaks the chip. The chip can get caught in the teeth of the die. The threads are on there. You don't have to thread this. You can chuck this up in your drill and just put a groove in there with a file. And then, so what the idea of this is to prevent theft, prevent it from blowing away. We're locking everything down. So this is gonna go into the wood here and screw in, maybe even put some epoxy on this. Epoxy, JB Weld. There it is. That's how it will look. So the next thing to do is to slip this on. And what I should have done when I did these holes, when I did the holes for the screws, I should have had this collar on there so that it gives clearance. I was having trouble with the collar hitting on there. So what I did, I just took a larger drill bit and hammered it down through here to expand this out. And that gave the collar room here to rotate properly. Tighten this down. Plenty of room. Here's how you're gonna set this up. So you've got this is attached. you know, let's say this is your fence post or your mailbox. Anyway, you got this post attached, right? Your Dubro wheel, 3/16 wheel collar. Slide it in here. And then let it drop down on there like that. Take this tiny little Allen wrench. Tighten this up. So when that big gust of wind comes, that can't come off. You can't just casually grab that Whirligig and walk off. And when the wind blows, you get a big gust, the airplane will not fly away. All right, that's pretty funny. I was ready to undo this and I came over and grabbed it. I'm like, oh, come out. So, really putting the pressure on there. And it's not going anywhere. Let's look at some of the other Whirligigs that this will work for. So here's the first idea I had, is just take an old Whirligig and, you know, piece of sheet, scrap sheet metal, right like that. That works. All right. And then we have just the, here's how this evolved. This was an idea to get in here with your oil, right? Give it a drop of oil. And then another variation on this, instead of having this underneath, you could have this collar in here. And this one's too big. You could have this collar in here like this. And then you really want to carry it to extremes. There's an idea. So you would have this on the bottom. You would through bolt it, go all the way through to the end, to the top. So there's another one. Found out I could hold these collars by the Allen key with the Allen wrench like so. Makes it easy to slip in here and fit right on there. And you're ready to tighten it up.